Hello everyone, Jay from FVSM here. Today, we're gonna take a look at two radios. Not from the build quality or the ergonomics, which are of course still very important, but those things are not what I'm good at. And you probably have seen a lot of review videos about them already. So instead, what we're gonna take a look at is the signals, the quality of the signals. So just a brief introduction of the two radios we have. This one is my DIY radio, which has the X9 Lite core with the IG01 gimbal. It's one of the famous gimbals in the racer community. And the shell or ergonomics are the classic JR radio, which is very similar to Terranis, I think. Let's consider it our control group. The other radio is the one I got from Jumper recently, which is their newest flagship T15. So today we're gonna take a look at the signals, see if it's actually better than this one, which is supposedly one of the top gimbals on the racing market. Now that we know what radios I'm using, next I'm gonna briefly talk about what approach I took to compare the radios. So here's the quad I used for comparison. It's bound to both radios. So it's bound to this radio and it's bound to this radio too. So you can actually fly with the quad with any of these radios. What I did is essentially fly the quad with one radio, collect the black box data, and then fly it with the other radio and also collect the black box data. And then we'll take a look at the black box data points. So both radios runs Express LRS 1000 Hz. In order to capture signals / noise up to 1000 Hz, we have to set the black box sampling rate to 2K by the Shannon theorem. Don't ask why, just set it to 2K so that you can actually sample 1K signals accurately. Once we've done that, here I recorded some black box. Let's take a look at the black box together. I'm using the FVSM black box analyzer to do the analysis. So here you can see I recorded some black box here. One is flying the same quad with this radio, my DIY radio with AG01 gimbal. And then the other two are flying the same drone with the Jumper T15 radios. So let's first take a look at the Jumper T15. Specifically, I want to look at the RC commands. And we actually have a one view for the RC commands. So if you so just click the drop down here, go to input and response. And here we only care about RC commands. Specifically, we're gonna use the spectrum graph for the analysis. If it's the first time you hear about spectrogram, here's some explanation from Gemini with pictures. So what is a spectrum graph? Imagine you have a magic paintbrush that can paint sounds. So you have a sound here, right? We all know that, you know, with a sound, you have bass, you have higher pitch sound, right? The spectrum graph essentially tells you how many of those voice falls into, you know, the bass part, how much of your voice falls into the higher pitch part. So imagine, you know, if I just speak like this, right? This part of the voice will probably have a very high bass part. And if I speak like this, you'll see higher numbers from the pitch part. Okay, that's just my layman's explanation of spectrum graph for voice. But, you know, essentially everything else is similar to voice. In here, the RC commands, you know, it just jumps around. Essentially, it's also like a voice, just at a different frequency. So since the signal overall is actually very clean, let's actually zoom in a little bit. Let's actually drag it to the maximum. So essentially here you can see, you know, majority of the signals, which are, you know, we move the gimbals, majority of the signals actually falls under, let's see, 20, you know, 25-ish, right? Majority of the signals. Those are probably, you know, my movements. Probably won't even be like over 20 or something, since, you know, you cannot move your hands that fast, like over 20 hertz. Like 1 second you move like 20 times, that's probably already too much. So essentially, you know, any signals above 50, right, is probably already noise. So in the most ideal world, we wouldn't want to see anything, you know, above, I would say 50 or something, you know, that threshold is debatable. But you definitely don't want to see anything above, you know, 100 hertz. There's also a little spike here at 1000. Those are probably, you know, the jitter, since we're running 1000 hertz, right? This is the jitter values. So this is the raw axis. Remember, we are comparing four channels, you know, raw, pitch, yaw, and throttle. And look at the pitch as well. Pitch is similar to raw, very similar. And then yaw, even less movement. And then throttle. Throttle, I guess we moved a lot, so it has more data here. Overall, that's the spectrum graph of the Jumper T15. Next, let's take a look at the data of our DIY H0 radio. Okay, instantly you can see that it has actually much higher spikes above like 100 Hertz here. Remember, let's compare it back to the Jumper T15. Compared to that, right, this is a lot cleaner. Let's come back to the H01. See, this is a lot more more signal on the higher frequency side. Arguably a lot noisier too. You can see like these little spikes, like those spiky hairs here. Those are all noises. That's the pitch axis. And if we take a look at the raw axis, it's slightly better, right? But still, like you can see all these hairy spikes. Those are not good. Those, you definitely don't want to see those in your radio signals. Coming back to pitch, pitch is especially bad, you know, compared to roll, right? Pitch is like so much worse. It almost feels like my hall sensor is faulty on the pitch axis, whereas the roll is actually kind of okay compared to pitch, you know. And then let's take a look at the yaw as well. Yaw is also okay, you know. Roll and yaw is actually okay. Although, you know, roll is actually hairier and yaw is a little better. And then throttle, also similar to yaw. So it seems like one of my, the pitch axis on my right gimbal is 40. I don't know whether it's you know, quality issue or I dropped it and broke something, or some dust got in there and broke it. No idea. But from the signal, you can see that it has a very big difference, especially the difference between these two axes. That's what worries me. And then you might ask, Jay, do you feel anything when you fly? I do, actually. So with this radio, if I set my feed forward boost to too high or feed forward smoothing to too low, I will definitely get uncontrollable drone jitters. That there's just no way you can figure it out. As a result, I have to use very high feed forward smoothing, like I think at least 80 to 85 with 1000 Hertz. But you know, a side effect of that is with high smoothing, you get more latency. If more latency, what's the point of getting to 1000 Hertz? Why not just use 500 Hertz, right? But with this radio, I can actually set my feed forward smoothing to be a lot more aggressive. Just to show you what my current settings are. Okay, I got my quad plugged in. Here's my current settings. My feed forward smoothness is 60 instead of, you know, with this radio, I have to set it to at least 80. And then my averaging is actually turned off. Boost is 8. Jitter reduction is just set it to 0. And then my receiver, I'm actually experimenting with this number recently. I was at 25. For this black box, I actually recorded at auto factor at 2.5, which is actually very low. But it seems to fly fine for me, at least in my yard. With this radio, I do feel I get a lot faster too, with these more aggressive settings, which has something to do with ergonomics for sure, but the signal quality definitely helped as well. Cool, hopefully you find it useful. If it does, please let me know and leave a like and subscribe. This is Jay from FPVSim. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.